Okay, this is part two of catching Mr. T. I'm gonna hold this down at the bottom here so I don't look too got my rope here. Mr. T is gonna be out here. Again, I'm holding this down low so it doesn't affect. I wanna catch him normally. His catching has been a little tougher lately because he's learned when I catch him, I hurt him. So to me, that's normal. So he's already starting to walk off. I'm gonna cut his drive line off. He's gonna stop. I'm gonna come in. Good boy. Give him a little bit of release. Cut that drive line off. He's trying to avoid the pressure. I put too much pressure. I made him turn away. So I'm gonna keep the pressure on. See, he hears me talking. That's kind of throwing him off a little bit. It's okay, Mr. T. I know. You know you gotta get caught. I'm gonna stop. Give him a little release. You're a good boy. See, he may think this camera is this other stuff that I'm using. Give him a step, let him relax, put a little pressure, still holding this rope. He sees the rope, he knows I'm gonna catch him. Little step, release, good boy, Mr. T. Letting him figure this out, standing there. Step, release. I know, you're a good boy. Switch hands with the camera and the rope. Step and release, good boy, Mr. T. You're okay. Touch that nose a little bit so he knows I'm not going right for his neck. I'm going to back away, give him release. Normally, I don't have to play his games. He'll walk up to me, but because I've been hurting him lately, he's nervous. He doesn't want to get caught. Very normal. He almost walked away right there. I don't know if you saw that. I looked down at the camera. When I looked up his head, it looked like he was targeting where he was going to go. Put him again. Of course, he got right behind this little sticker bush. He created a barrier with these stickers, knowing that I got to go around him. So when I go around him, he's going to go the opposite way. Stupid horse outsmarting me. Poor Mr. T. I know. So I know he's got a draw to these horses. That horse, buddy's out there eating. So he's got all these draws, so I've got him in a corner. So he's facing me. He's facing all his draws. He's facing where he wants to be. So I don't want him to break left, my left, because that gets him to his horses. So I'm going to put a little pressure on him so I don't have to walk these stickers, and I'm going to back him up a little bit. Come in his head, put a little pressure and push on him. You're okay. He backed up. Now I can get around these stickers without going around them. And without stepping on him too much. Good boy. He backed up. That's okay, Mr. T. It's okay, bud. I don't want to get by your neck. I know you're nervous. I know he's a good boy. I'm going to reach in under his neck. And he moved. He said no. Cut that line off. Can't let him get past me. He's in a sticker. Good boy. I'm going to go to his back. Easy. He's not going to let me go to his back. Go to his butt. He says, hell no. Mr. T, you're being a bad boy. You're being a bad horsey. Still keeping that pressure. I got him in his corner here, so this is where I get a horse hurt if I put too much pressure. I can force him to rear or try to push through this fence, and I'm not putting too much pressure on him. And he'll run through me, and I know how to let him through if I put too much. But you get a horse in his corner, and you get aggressive right here, and then that's how you get a horse hurt. He'll cut his neck. He'll swing it by these fences. He'll hit his head. I don't want to do that. So I'm going to go and pet him, let him know that I can come in. I got his path blocked, and now I'm going to reach underneath his neck and see if I can get this rope around the back of his neck. Again, he don't want me by his head. It hurts. I've been putting this medicine on it that stings and burns and poking him. Stand. Easy. Stand. You're all right. I know. You're okay. I know. I'm reaching under his neck. He doesn't like this. Got a cat coming out here messing up the program. You're going to get stepped on, bud. That's a good move. That's a smart cat. Come on, Mr. T. I know, buddy. So another problem I'm running into is I don't want to, and again, I'm holding this camera down low because I'm walking him, so I don't know what I'm filming. If you don't like it, turn it off. I want to hear your whining. Poor Mr. T's in hurt. So I got the rope around his neck here, just kind of leading him this way, because I don't want to put a regular halter on his nose, because it goes right across the injured area. Doing some research on Mr. T's injury, I saw that abscesses on the back of the pole are not as uncommon as I would think, and sometimes they're caused by people tying a horse and making them rear and trying to do too much. Good boy, Mr. T. I know you're a good boy. So I'm going to bring Mr. T over here. And then I'm going to have to set this camera down because he's not going to let me. I know you're a good boy. I know. I got to put this on. I know. Poor Mr. T. Poor Mr. T. I gotta stay away from that neck. I know, easy, easy. I wanna get around that injury, and I'm not putting this on very tight. A very, very loose. All right. Hi, Mr. T. I know, bud. Now, he doesn't want me by his neck at all. I know, it's okay. So I'm going to pet his neck here. And it almost looks like it's swollen more now. I know. See, if I touch his neck here, when I move his hair up here, it just hurts. So I have to be really careful. I don't want this rope halter messing with that. I gotta move his mane, and that tickles him. And he does. I know, Mr. T. That red knot there was not there. And the vet's coming out tomorrow again, by the way, people. This will be your fourth trip to look at it and see what we do. That little red knot actually looks very different. Before, it was just his shaved hair. That was really bad. If I can get him to lower his head a little bit. Head. I know you're a good boy. Head. Just a little bit. Head. I know you can drop it. You were eating. Head. Good boy. He doesn't want this camera by him. He thinks I'm going to touch it. So, again, when I touch this, he's very, very... Look at that head. Look at that. He's telling me... No, he's telling me it hurts. Don't hurt me. Not being mean. Not... He just doesn't want me messing with that, and I don't blame him. This thing has been a pain in the butt. It's okay, Mr. T. And I think he's been rubbing. This is him rubbing this himself. So he's rubbing this hair off out there, scratching it, which I don't care. I want him to be able to scratch it. If that makes him feel better, if that'll help pop it, I'm okay with that. I'm kind of... don't know if I should put that Ichthammol on there. I will, just to show you. But I may not get the red stuff. It's okay, Mr. T. He hates his cap. He hears this coming off and he's like, dude, what the hell? This is, I lost a horse. Where'd Buddy go? I gotta make sure he didn't get in the tack room because he's pulling something out, snacks. Where the hell did he go? Stupid horse ran off on me. Buddy, where'd you go? Oh, there he is. See, he's a good boy. I was calling him names. He's eating. All right. So this is the Ichthammol. It's supposed to draw, and I might be saying it wrong. I don't know how the hell you say it. But I-C-H-T-H-A-M-M-O-L, 20% drawing salve. Sorry, I had to scratch my face. Had this on my hand. So, I'm going to try and put some of this on this for Mr. T.